I'm Bob Camp, co-creator of Ren and Stimpy. And if you're not watching Opinionated Monsters, there's something really wrong with you and you better straighten it out. You got it? Thanks.
Welcome to the Opinionated Monsters. I'm Scott McClellan of Carnival Diablo.
I'm Sonzi from OttawaHorror.com.
I'm Kevin the Zombie King from ZombieInfo.com.
And I'm Jessica, child psychologist.
Well, today is a very special day because we're looking at unnecessary remakes. Oh, yes. And not just unnecessary ones. Really, as far as I'm concerned, crappy and unnecessary ones. And it's going to be this time Halloween.
I'm probably the weirdest one to start with because Halloween, the first 1978 version, was probably the most important film in the world to me.
Yes!
It was made, I was very, very young when it came out, so I didn't get to see it, of course. But a few years later, they actually started playing it on TV and, well, you know, I watched it anyway. At that time, the most successful independent horror film of all time. Step into the remake. It's announced. It's, people are excited. Rob Zombie, again, super exciting filmmaker, puts out Halloween, the remake. Now, they actually rushed it in the theater. I saw it in the theater, but I also went to the unrated director's cuts, and I also did that with part two, which is, again, like I said, it's sort of an extension to make one big, great thing. I thought part two was a big steaming pile of shit. And I couldn't have hated a movie more, especially for something that felt so close and important to me. All that being said, the remake Halloween itself, not good as a remake. However, in my view, it stands as a companion piece to those years, no, not comparing it to but it stands as a companion piece to those years if you gave a crap. But the problem is, not once when I watched the original did I think Michael Myers came from a trailer park. That being said, like I said, the original, strong, super wonderful, be-all, end-all to film. The second one, a great extension of that. This one, remake, it's a companion piece at best. And that's really all I can defend it.
I actually agree with a lot of the things that Kevin's saying. I don't really consider the Rob Zombie remake an unnecessary remake because I don't really consider it a remake. If you approach it from the standpoint of it's a retelling, it's how the story of Michael Myers should have been told from Rob Zombie's perspective, it succeeds admirably at that. I think it's a very good example of how filmmaking has changed from the 70s to now, you know, because you have the original John Carpenter's Halloween, where there's not really any need for, you know, the backstory. Why is he like this? How did this happen? Because that's just how movies were. You didn't really care. Now you kind of need that. And I actually thought it was very interesting, the concept of, you know, here's where he came from. You see his first kill and the progression. He didn't just decide one day, okay, well, I guess I'm going to kill people on Halloween and, you know, take a 15-year break and I'm out, so why not go back to it, you know? You see the progression up to that point. You see how he was in interacting with other people. I think that that's great. Where I think the movie failed was a lot of the things didn't really make sense, you know. For example, Michael Myers listened to Kiss as a kid. That explains everything. No, it doesn't. Rob Zombie has this tendency to write these characters as kind of, you know, lower class, lower income people. And I almost feel as though almost every character that he writes is Rob Zombie, you know, because that's what he knows, so that's what he writes. And there's nothing wrong with that. But I feel like that
the source material, though,
it really doesn't play well into our conceptions of what Michael Myers' home life was, you know, because it is so disparate. I agree. Halloween 2, the remake, I have no idea what was going on. I think that it was really just a case of, you know, hey, the first one did well. Rob, you know.
Keep going.
Because if you watch just the first one, he tells the story beautifully. You know, it was supposed to be a standalone piece.
Yeah.
And as a standalone piece, perfect.
While you agree with me on Rob Zombie's version, though, I can't agree that you just didn't need that in the 70s. I think not having the explanation added to the mystery of what Michael Myers came to be, to the point where people would theorize like
Michael
crazy.
Michael Myers was the boogeyman.
Exactly.
He was almost supernatural. Like,
yes.
Good God, he kept on being almost killed, and he'd sit up again. I didn't want to think of him as a human.
Right.
And his backstory meant nothing to me, because the fact that really he wasn't supposed to be human. He was subhuman. There was something horrifying about him.
Pure evil. And that would be my problem with the remake. Now, I'm always the guy who says, bring something new to the table, right? So, arguably, Rob Zombie's Halloween is a perfect remake by my standard, right? Except for one problem. You cannot, when you remake, and especially when you remake a franchise, you cannot violate canon. And it violated canon because the point of Michael Myers wasn't that his mother was a prostitute, wasn't that he listened to Kiss, wasn't. This kid was pure, to quote Loomis, pure and simply evil. What happened in there is not unimportant. It's important that we don't know. It's important that that is not there, because that makes the monster all the scarier. That makes him the boogeyman. I really wanted to like Rob Zombie's Halloween. I mean, I love Devil's Rejects, so I was like, okay, let's see what he does with Halloween. I was looking forward to his visual style. Malcolm McDowell is Loomis.
It's pretty, it was pretty
I'm like,
perfect,
oh my
yeah.
God, how can you screw this up with that cast?
He's pretty much the
well,
only guy who could have done it, except for Pleasance.
Yeah, and I got there and I'm like, meh. It really just didn't, it didn't do anything for me. Meh. Meh. That was my literal reaction was meh. And then Halloween 2 came out, and I'm like, seriously, you're going to make a sequel to a remake? Let me repeat this for emphasis. A sequel to a remake, or a remake of a sequel. Does anybody else?
Timeline.
Does anybody else think this is a spectacularly bad idea? If you're doing a remake, the recipe needs to be different, but you can't serve somebody burger if they're expecting cake.
Yeah.
And that's what he did. He gave us a hamburger. We wanted cake, and it was not
a weird choice for a vegan.
Oddly enough,
cake.
Whew. Well. I have to say this right off the top. Halloween 1977 was a very important time period because it changed the way we looked at slashers, and it also gave us a fantastic character
that was a non-character.
Because he never spoke. You never really saw his face, and yet he was very powerful on screen. Now, that being said, I am a big lover of the movie Halloween, and when I was told that Rob Zombie was going to be doing a remake, I was excited for a moment because I really enjoyed House of a Thousand Corpses, that maybe he would lend his rock and roll virility to this wonderful, iconic character and make it, like, you know, again, the boogeyman in a really cool way. What ended up happening was the complete opposite. It was a cluster of stupidity. I was supposed to watch this again before we did the episode here, and I thought to myself, I can't put myself through watching this a second time. There was nothing redeeming about it. No, there was nothing redeeming about the film. I don't care about 2 because 2 was poo and number 1 was dung. It was like...
It did make Love Hurts a terrifying song, though.
I don't care about any of the music involved or anything. It was terribly done. It didn't touch on any of the real things that I wanted to see it touch on. I didn't give a crap, a rat's ass, about where Michael came from because, like I said a few moments ago, Michael was the boogeyman. What the hell were they doing humanizing him?
Exactly.
Not dehumanizing. They were making him like a guy that lives in a trailer park.
We don't want somebody
I don't
for
give
him.
A about that. It's like, this is a movie that could have been great a second time around in the late 90s, early 21st century. Instead, it wasn't a movie at all. It was just a piece of and it shouldn't have been made. It should not have been made. It was a waste of digital, celluloid, time, everything. I'm sorry that Malcolm McDowell even had his name attached to this piece of crap. And you know what? I like Rob. I think Rob Zombie's brilliant, and I'm sorry that he is attached to this piece of crap because his name is now synonymous with crap because of this. Even the mask. They should never have done anything to that mask. They made it look mean. Well, it wasn't supposed to look mean. It was supposed to look like that mask.
Yeah, but it was that mask that just got old. It was hidden under the floorboards.
I don't care. It looked mean. Oh, it looked mean. It had almost like it had mean brows. It's like when people make skulls with mean brows, skulls don't work that way. It's like skulls are scary without mean brows. So is Michael Myers' mask. You know? Enough said. Okay? Enough said.
Deep breaths. Calm blue ocean.
White sandy beach.
Rivers red.
White sandy beach.
Blood beach.
What?
Never mind.
Okay.
Red sandy or red rivers red.
Red
red
sandy
blood
beach.
Red.
Red rivers blood.
Red rivers blood.
Red
rivers blood.
Red rum. Red rum.
So, let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Was the Halloween an unnecessary remake? Do you share Scott and I's opinion that it was a steaming pile of you-know-what? Or are you more like those other two and think that maybe it had some merit?
And of course, subscribe, because that's the most important thing. You want to be a part of what's going on constantly. And I want to hear from you guys, because I'm hoping that you have some opinions too. I had some tonight, that's for sure.
And don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. You can follow us on Instagram now, and of course, at theopinionatedmonsters.com.
Mm-hmm.
Because we don't have to watch it again.
I'm not going to watch it ever again.